Hey there, son folk. Welcome back to the channel. This is Sean, the sign guy. Today, I'm going to be doing a little bit of maintenance. Actually, I'm working on my Q54, aka Graphtec FC8600. I think I said that right. About 2 weeks ago, I was cutting some vinyl, and when I went to hit the crosscut, the leading edge of that vinyl actually went in the gutter of where the cutter actually goes down to perf cut, you know, that gutter right in front of the Teflon strip. And unfortunately, I had about 24 inches of vinyl get smushed into a 1-inch space. So what happened is when the vinyl came back up, it all bunched behind this, my cutting head carriage. And inadvertently after that, the cutting head wasn't the same. So it felt like there was something still stuck back behind there. I've had my cutter for 9 years, something like that. I can't remember, 8, 9, 10 years, whatever. Thing's been a rock solid piece of equipment, never let me down. But I never clean the back of those bearings. I do clean the front and the side of the machine just aesthetically, but you know, dirt and crap and fuzzies and you know, junk gets in those bearings. So I kind of figure that's what happened. So today I'm going to disassemble the cutter. I'm actually going to break it all the way down to the printhead carriage, and I have two spare bearings in the event that one of them cracked, because I kind of have a feeling that's what happened. I already took the carriage apart once. The carriage actually has 8 bearings in it, and I didn't want to take the carriage totally off unless I had some replacement parts. And so I reached out to Sign Warehouse to get the parts. Graphtec, the 8600 and the Q54, basically it's the same thing. The only way that I could get the parts was through Sign Warehouse, that are still Graphtec, rebranded, blah, blah, blah. Anyways, those little bearings are like $40 freaking a piece. Let me show you. Those little things, $40 a piece, and it takes 8 of them. So I got 2 spares. I'm going to take the carriage apart. Hopefully I find out the problem, but so that's what this video is about. Replacing and cleaning the carriage bearings on a vinyl cutter. So stick with me. I'm going to show you step by step how I get it done. All right, guys. So rule number one, anytime that you're working on electronic equipment, turn it off. Disconnect the power. So this cutter is really easy to work on. So essentially, I'm going to remove 4 screws, 4 on this side, 4, the side covers come off, and then you have this top piece that needs to come off, but you need to remove this control panel first. It's held on with 3 screws, 1, 2, 3, and once that comes off, there's 2 ribbon cables that you have to be very careful with. And get those separated. So, and we're going to do it step by step so that we can actually get to the those little bearings back here. That's kind of what I'm going to show you guys. So first thing you want to do is remove these screws. It helps to have a magnetic tip screwdriver as well. So when this comes off, this kind of goes forward. So what you want to do with these ribbons is they only go on one way. You want to take them very carefully, wiggling them back and forth until they pop out. I wasn't very careful, but there we go. Next thing we need to do is remove this top cover. I don't want to lose any of these screws. So if you're working on carpet, good luck to you. These
Jeez.
Here we go. Comes off. So the next thing that you're going to want to do, I can see there's one, two, these wires, all those need to be disconnected. That one we're going to leave, I think. So we'll see. But two screws on the side of the carriage. This one definitely needs to come all the way out. And you can take your blade holder out if need be. We're just going to take this all the way out. Here we go. So there's that, because I'm going to put these screws in there so I don't get any of that stuff screwed up. So as you can see, there's actually one, two, three, four screws, but there's an Allen head that holds that plate on that holds these bearings. So essentially what we're going to end up doing, let's take this out just to give us some more room. That's not a big deal. So these essentially just pull out, actually grab them on the side. See where that the little angles are there? Don't pull by the wires, pull it by the plastic. That, those come out, and you're gonna have to cut that little zip tie there as well. So these ribbon cables you have to be very careful with, but they just pull right out. Get that one out of the way. And we are going to just basically pull that on the sides very carefully. And this just basically gives you enough room that you can work on everything. Again, put that there, set it to the side. So now this is free. So when it goes back on, like I said, you're just gonna have to remember that's how it goes. So next thing we're going to do is cut that zip tie. Yours may be clear. Like I said, I've been here once before. Yes. And just cut that zip tie. There's two screws that hold this front carriage on. There's this screw and then this screw back here. This one right here is tricky because this magnet or this motor is actually magnetized, which makes it fun getting that screw back in. And there's only one way that this will set in there level. So as you can see, the back of the holes are ovaled on both sides. So essentially, there's only one way that this can actually go back in. So don't worry about screwing this up. Let's grab some needle nose pliers. And grab that for now. Set it there. And then this one. Set this guy to the side. If you ever wanted to know what the back of these look like, there you go. This is the actual cross cut blade when it comes down. And then this is the optical eye that measures your crop marks. So yeah, there's that. Set it to the side. Careful, don't want to damage that. And so now we can address the carriage. As you can see, there's eight bearings. There's one, two, three, four, five, six, and then there's two more like this underneath the backside, 7, 8. So the next thing that I need to do is essentially take this carriage off so that we can look at the bearings. Make sure there's no damage. This one's not even riding. That one's too tight. Those are okay. So we need some adjustment here. So that's gonna be step two. Now that the carriage is off, pretty easy to get to this point. So the next thing is seeing if we can find the problem here. Okay, guys, so the next step, now that we are at the point to the carriage, we're gonna have to remove these screws to release the belt so we can gain access to the back of the carriage to access these bearings. So what I recommend doing is these on the left-hand side of your plotter, these are the tensioning screws for the belt. What I did is I just took a black Sharpie, I just colored in some of the screw thread on the top and on the bottom, and then loosen the tension on the belt. And you can see that the belt actually now has some slack in it. You want to give it about a quarter of an inch on both sides because it relieves the tension so that now we can take these screws out. These are just the belt retainers, and we're going to take both sides off. One, two, there's that. And we will set these to the side. Now, if you're wondering how this attaches back, there's some grooves on this plate that essentially the belt just kind of locks in. And then this tab prevents it from coming out. So we're going to do that on both sides. Now, there is an encoder on the cutter, and it is actually not in time or sync with the belt. The belt just moves the carriage, and essentially the cutter head knows where it needs to be. So that one's got some double-sided tape on it. We're just gonna leave that one there. We're just gonna let that hang down there. And it's probably a good idea to inspect the belt at this point too. Make sure it doesn't have any foreign debris in it. Make sure it's all nice and clean. Doesn't look overly bad. I'm probably gonna take a toothbrush to it just to make sure that there's nothing else in there. So at this point, we need to remove that Allen bolt and these four screws across the top. You can see that I actually marked them just to kind of give me an idea as far as where this needs to be set back on when we go to reinstall it.
Okay, so now that we have our bearings, our new bearings set in, I want to point out a couple of important factors here. So when you reinstall these bearings, these screws are countersunk. And what happens is when you tighten that screw down, these bearings still have a little play in it, and you can see. And that does affect how the bearings contact the raceway. And in theory, you want all eight bearings touching the raceway to provide the smoothest surface for the bearings to travel on. So when I tighten these up, I'm actually going to push them forward just a little bit, just to make sure that they all make contact. That was one of the problems that I had trying to reinstall this. The other thing that I want to point out is this top carrier that has the bearings, it attaches up here, and essentially these bars are spring-loaded. So you have no adjustment on the back of the carriage. These are stationary bearings. Other than the screws pretty much centering the bearings as best as they can on the carriage. So what I like to do is, as you can see, I have bent this carriage down a little bit just to provide a little bit more pressure on that side of the bearing and that side of the bearing when I reassemble. Another important thing that you will want to know is that when you reinstall this piece, you want to start your Allen head screw back in that hole and thread it maybe two threads. That's it, because there's not a lot of room on the raceway. So now that you have your carriage back up underneath, again, doing this one-handed is kind of tricky. It's the one side, push it up there on the other. Now, this screw and this screw are still loose. I'm going to set my tension, and then I'm going to set my final adjustments with these screws by when the carriage is in this position so that it rolls nice and smooth. There we go. So I'm going to proceed to tighten the Allen screw, install these last four screws up top, and get this sucker back together. Use my Allen wrench here. And slowly put this screw back in. This is the most painstaking part about this whole process. Carriage is back on. Rolls pretty smooth. Still feel some crap in there. So the big thing, when you do this, you do not want any play in the carriage. You don't want it to go, you don't want it going left or right. You don't want it going front or back. So, and by putting tension on these bars, it actually brings it right in. And so the only other thing that I have to do, I'm going to connect the belt again and then set my tension on these wheels, and then I'm actually going to install those last four wheels, and then we can get the rest of the carriage back together. Adjust the tension on the belt, and again using the marks from the Sharpie. That's about where that one was. We're gonna make sure that this slides nice and free. I don't hear any noises. I don't hear any clicking. So now we're going to install the four screws up top. We're just going to put these back in. Don't tighten those yet. So now that we have the carriage back together, you want to make sure that there is no play in this carriage. You want it to move nice and freely back and forth. You want to make sure that there's equal pressure on the carriage against the rail. And the way that I do that is I just feel the bearings and make sure with the belt tension, it should be holding it up against the rail enough to where it should provide tension. So the only one is, that one's got a little bit, out a little bit, but so now that we have the carriage in the position, I'm going to use my hand and put pressure underneath and my thumb, putting pressure on the rail, and then I'm going to finish tightening these four screws up top. Don't cinch these inside ones down yet. Get these outside ones snug so that it does not move. And again, check for play. You want no play in or out, left or right, or diagonally. Last little cinch. Nice and smooth. So the last thing that we need to do is tighten up these two top bearings, because those were the ones that were kind of out of whack. And again, check and make sure that your bearings are rolling on the raceway, and then just tighten these two top screws. Therefore, you have tension on all four bearings.
top, bottom, I'm sorry, 8 bearings. So there you go.
Now we can reverse the process of getting the carriage back on. And this is pretty elementary. Just make sure that everything's cleaned out. Like I said, it's easier to check all that stuff now that it's off. There's not really a lot that that can go wrong with these things. But just make sure everything's working, and yeah, let's give it a good once over and it should be good. And again, this only goes on one way. So you're gonna use this screw hole and that screw hole to reattach the carriage. Make sure that ribbon cord is out of the way. You don't want to over tighten this. And this is where the needle nose comes in handy, because of the magnet of the motor. I get the screw in. And then I can get the screwdriver in there. Next, we are going to do this board, the control board. Super tight, but just snug it down. Next part of the process is reconnecting the wires. Now on these plugs, they have a tab on the very top of them. That obviously goes up because these only go in one way. Back in the guide. Let's get these guys in there. Again, the pin goes up top. Snaps back in. This one does not have a pin. This one actually has guides on the side. But it just snaps back in. Now with these ribbon cables, I like to put this one in first. And this one is actually kind of tricky. You just have to be very careful not to fender break it. So I essentially just line it up to where it needs to go. And I push from the back here. Just kind of wiggle it back and forth. Until there are no more gold contacts. It fits in there nicely. Get this one's a little bit easier because you have a little bit more room on the ribbon. Just goes into the connector. Again, you just shimmy it back and forth a little bit until it won't go in any further. So it looks like all of our connections are done. All of our screws are tight. I got those two. Everything seems to be moving nice and smooth. So now everything moves nice and free. So let's go ahead and get the top cover back on, and then we can get our instrument panel, and then we can test to make sure that everything is working the way that it should. Next, we have our control panel to put back on. Again, you have the little ribbon cable inserts, and this only goes in one way. Again, putting these back in is just a matter of putting them in and sliding them back and forth.
Slide them back in there until they bottom out.
It's the easy part.
Again, you got little tabs on the front. They just insert into the top of the cover. And then you have your three screws on the back. So to get to this point, let's go ahead and turn the cutter on, make sure that everything is working properly. Plugged in, turned on. Hopefully something comes up on the screen. Cutter's on, let's go ahead and get, I'm just gonna throw a piece of scrap in there. Nice. All right, YouTubers, so that's how you do that. 254 Graphtec FC8600, that's a lot of numbers to remember. That's the carriage replacement, alignment, adjustment, bearings, the whole nine yards. So the only thing left to do at this point is I have to install the cover on the carriage itself. I have to install the left and right covers and the three screws for the back of the control panel. So, and that's pretty much it. That wraps it up. I hope this helps you guys out. Like I said, if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me, leave a comment below, and thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.